Hi, this is Khalil, and here is my group members, Ahmed and Mohammed. This is our lovely lecturer, Abdulqadir Abdulqasim. And here is our title. We have a motor mouth brain. We don't mean it as someone who talks a lot, but we mean it literally a motor mouth that will be controlled using the brain. So anyway, let's crack on. Okay, so what is the situation we are trying to handle? So let's say we have a handicapped person and he's deaf or mute, or he can't talk with the others. So we need to enable him to communicate with the others without letting him to learn the sign language. Some of them find it difficult, and because all both the ordinary people and the handicapped one needs to know it or to learn it. So it's not kind of practical a bit. So what we suggest, or our solution, is to use the P300 and using the brain waves, and then sending them as a data to the robot, so that the robot will be will recognize them, and he will try to do whatever the user is trying to do, and also to say whatever the user is trying to say. So here is the process we went through. We used the P300 splitter to capture the electroencephalographies of the user brain. And then it was converted by the spiller to a text. And happily that the spiller provides us with an external connection with other applications. So we used a UDP user datagram protocol to communicate with a server that runs the robot. We add the cognitive text to speech TTS engine so that we allow the robot to execute the text and then deliver them as a sound. So we also use the natural language processing, NLP. We will get to this one in the next few slides. We have used hardware such as cameras, motors, and we control them using Arduinos and Raspberry kits. We needed an extensive program to synchronize these kits, the motors, with whatever the user is trying to perform or to do. So here is the robot who will be talking on behalf of the user. Hopefully you can hear the sound.
We don't have the sound, but you can just click the share screen button again, and please enable the share computer music icon.
Okay, let me try it. Oops.
So when you press the button, there should be a little radio button with share computer sound.
Okay, let me see. Select a speaker or select a microphone, MacBook. Same as system.
Do you see the share screen button?
Yes.
Click on it.
Okay.
Now you should see a little radio button with share computer music or computer sound.
Okay, just a sec. It asks for my password.
Can see your password.
Okay. Can you hear the sound now?
No.
So, I enable.
Nightworks. Nightworks. I can hear it.
Okay, I think it's okay. So, I was trying to say hi, the letter C, and he's saying the letter C on behalf of me. So also
hello,
we
how are you?
Have this, hi. So now he said the hi, how are you? Sorry for that. Okay, let's move to the next one. Why I'm not able to control. Okay, so here's some of the features we've implemented on the robot. So we allow the user to have the option between switching, to switch between the female and male voice. Also there is another option the user can use, which is the chatbot. He can enable the, he can make the robot autonomous and answers and answer the question that the user himself is not, that he's not willing to answer. Let's say someone asking, what's your name? What's your age? The user will not need to bother himself answering these questions. So the robot will answering them autonomously. So here I was telling him, what is the date today? And he was saying today is the 17th of October. Okay, there is the motors. The robot also has some motors in his face. We tried to give an access to the user to use the P300 to control all of them so that he can express his emotions using these motors. Let me show you what happens when we enable all the motors we have on the face. So he can blink, he can move his cheeks, the nose, and his mouth. Okay, we have the camera. It has image recognition to tell the user who's you're talking with. And if I am deaf, it'll convert the speech to a text that I can read. So this system can be used not only by the handicapped people, but also can be used by the individuals, normal ones. Let's say by the important people, such as you guys and me, I'm just kidding, to attend meeting. And let's say we think that meeting will end up throwing hands or something, so we don't really want to attend it. So we can send this robot on behalf of us to attend that one. Some of you will say, why don't we just establish an online meeting? Well, I agree with you, but I also strongly believe that we can, by having a physical, when you physically present to the audience, it'll deliver more senses to them. So this is why I think it's better to have someone who represents you in a state of not attending meetings at all. So we have some of the challenges we face. We have the buffer overflow. There was a buffer overflow at the server side because we were sending huge values to be executed by the robot. We tried to maximize the buffer size as much as we could. Also, there are a couple of dummy icons wasn't working. We simply eliminated them and replaced them with another ones. We tried to write an efficient program so that we can maintain the efficiency of the program and minimize the delay we have between the requests and replies. The time limitation wasn't a big issue. So here is some of the pictures while people were working in the project. Thank you.